Jesus,
people for 5,000 years have been so stupid they couldn't realize this obvious fact.
I'm saying, forget about all the other people in the 2000.
No, I'm saying, let me finish like the guy over there.
Excuse me.
Totally
let me finish at least my sentence. Let me finish my sentence. If you believe that Jesus Christ is your main role model, the best man, the best, what do you say, the best,
your savior,
the best creation, or creator, whatever you call it. Yes. If you believe his words are worthy more than these people of 2,000 years of history, then you would believe. Then you would believe what Jesus said, and you would acknowledge, and you would acknowledge that according to Jesus Christ and according to his belief on earth, the only true God is just one person, and that is only the Father,
one person,
and not Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Because of one verse that you take out.
Yes.
Yes.
The whole one verse destroyed the entire
New
Testament.
Yes.
What about if it really was that persuasive, you can be sure there would have been a lot of people throughout the last 2,000 years who would have come to that same conclusion.
Actually, they did.
That's
the reason they left Christianity, many of them, because of words like that.
No, so where is the historical evidence that said we used to believe this, but we came
but why
to
why you want to go to Jesus Christ?
Can I ask you a very simple question? Is this verse unclear about who Jesus is identifying as the only true God?
Yeah, we've
sorry.
About
is
Matthew
it clear on
you? You won't
sorry.
Accept Matthew.
You won't accept it, right? John 7:3. I can
so
understand
here,
that.
Been on it for half an hour.
Jesus is quite clearly identifying there is one person of the Father.
One true God.
Who is that?
And one true God, he identifies as the Father. Is the Father
you
now...
You identified him as the Father.
No, Jesus did.
Yeah.
Well, you have, so I know
are
you don't saying, like it. This is the second time
are you saying... Can I have your Bible again?
Yes.
Because verse 1 starts with identifying this God to be the Father.
Actually, he already said that you, that is the Father.
Look, he clarified. After Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the hour has come. He continues, Father.
Yeah.
So he's addressing the Father and says, you, meaning...
Yeah, good.
Wait,
yeah.
So
good.
Slowly.
Yeah.
So according to Christ, self-identification. The only true God, not a God, not true God, only true God. That means you cannot have any other gods apart from this God.
Yeah.
And that is the Father. My simple question, next question is the Father three person or one person? The answer I will tell you. Tell me whether you agree or disagree. The Father is one person, not three persons. Right. So according to Christ, in essence then, the only true God is one person. According to Christians, the only true God is how many persons? Three. Whose side is Christ on? Your side or our side?
Christ is on the side. Look at,
on the side
like
of the
I
truth.
Said, no. You, if I were you, I would ask again, how is it that people have been so stupid for 2,000 years not to give...
I would give you...
No, the way you do
why
it
why would
you
go against Jesus Christ's teaching?
There are people who have written their reasons on how they understand John 17.
I can tell you
there's
why.
Hundreds
okay,
of
how do you understand it? Let's see. How do you understand it?
That
you tell
he
me.
Believed
yes?
that he always spoke of him as the true God, but that he was
no.
the Son, and but he didn't... He didn't
so according to him,
with his own voice,
how do you understand John 7:3? Tell me please. How do you understand
that
John 7:3?
Wants them
who is
to
the
know
he? Who is the he?
Jesus.
Okay, Jesus wants to know.
Want them to know that
okay. Oh, you see what I mean?
Read it.
Yeah.
When they read it themselves, they cannot disagree with it. Only if they disagree with it, then you're disagreeing with Jesus.
Pointing while he was it's 3 years as the Messiah, he's pointing to the Father in heaven.
As what? As what? He's pointing to the Father as what?
As what the only
wait, wait, no.
As what?
As what? Exactly, as what?
As what?
What is it pointing to the Father as?
Shema Yisrael, Yehovah Eloheinu, Yehovah Achaz.
Yes,
so
means,
what is
this
mean? Elohim.
The term Yehovah is not here.
Jehovah.
The term Jehovah is not there.
So he is...
Don't go to Mark 12:29.
You say
stick to
Jehovah
John 7:3.
Is not in the Bible.
My friend.
It's there 6,000 times.
But not in the New Testament. What, not even once. Zero times.
Well, you know, it's in Greek.
What's in Greek? So where is the true...
When it says
where is
God,
the true Bible
it's Kurios.
Where exactly
Lord,
do you
make God.
So he agrees with me,
it's
not Yahweh.
So what do you
okay, okay, so first of all,
yes.
It says in John chapter 17, verse 1, when Jesus has spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes and said, Father, the hour has come, glorify your Son, that the Son may go for right. And he said, I'm the Son, I'm the Son of God.
Carry on. The question
so how is it, how is it you can accept one
okay.
part and not the other?
You know what? When you say, the Son, do you know that in Luke, 3, when it tells you about the genealogy of Jesus, it calls Adam as the son of God. Would you agree with that? How many sons has your God got?
What happened? The first son.
Well, it says the son.
The son.
Okay, I'll give you one more.
Two kids. He had one Adam and
Eve. I'll give you one more.
The daughter.
My friend.
Who was the daughter?
No problem. By the way,
daughter was
by the way, in that, does it say the first son? It doesn't say.
Well,
in fact, I'll give you one more.
No, but he's not. The way he's different from Adam the son.
I will answer.
He's not just a generic son.
I will answer one at a time.
That was there. It says, I glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you gave me to do.
Oh, wait, why did you skip all the other two verses? You went to verse 4.
No, I'll do that too.
So do it then. Do it first before you jump to 4.
We'll start right from the beginning. Let's do
read
the
verse 2 now.
Let's
verse 2.
Read all 4.
Yes.
God, when please. Jesus had spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you. Now, he wasn't talking about glorify all humanity, all the people.
Of course, glorify only Jesus.
Only
no one. Problem. Yes. We have no problem. Okay.
And he's the Son.
Yeah, we'll come to that.
Son, yes. Right? Since you have given him authority over all flesh, he has not given that authority over
He was
anyone.
A prophet, the messenger. He had authority over all people. Like all the other prophets.
Yeah.
Moses had authority in his time.
That was not...
Carry on.
Yeah. But this is unlike anyone else we've ever
My
seen.
My friend, can you stop like giving an exegesis?
But you have to...
Or rather, exegesis?
Giving your exegesis
but
now.
You've given him authority over all flesh to give eternal life to all whom you have given him.
Yeah. Carry
so
on.
He has the power to give eternal life. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth.
Why no commentary for that? What happened? Oops.
Yeah,
why? Right. Give me the commentary for that. Come on, like the other ones.
That's why Jesus came, is that by him dying on the cross.
What did he mean when he says this is...
I'm telling you.
Yes.
By Jesus, the Son, coming and dying on the cross, he was the only one who was truly able and had the ability to die in the place of other people.
Nothing about that in there.
To pay for their sins. So, but it's all over in the rest
and
of John.
From
if you
the
read
dead.
The rest
you know
of
this
John,
is,
you'll
this
see
is called disingenuous. Because
he
for the other two, wait.
So that
wait a minute.
People get saved
what's
and then
what's your name, by the way?
Through his death.
Yeah. What's your name?
And resurrection.
David? Yeah. You know, you gave a very clear commentary.
Resurrection.
The whole book of David. When you gave the commentary for the first two verses, you gave a very precise commentary based on the context of the verse only. But when it came to 3, you went completely off tangent.
Off the whole book of John. Look at the whole book.
Did we ask for the whole book?
Yeah, but if
for the other two verses, he didn't give the whole book, did he?
Yeah.
But when it came to verse 3, which is the kryptonite of the Trinitarians, he gave a commentary of the whole book, which we didn't ask for. So
yeah,
once again, David, with all due respect, can you please give a commentary of verse 3 only? What happened?
Jesus, the only fact Jesus could even say it's eternal life.
Can you at least include the title in that? The only true God when you give your commentary.
Yeah, what do you mean by that?
So whom was he giving?
Whom
was he giving this title? Whom did Jesus give this title to?
He gave it to...
How could he know Jesus now? If he's dead, he rose from the
dead. Why are you reluctant to answer it?
Because you asked for an explanation of John 17, chapter 3, verse 3.
Yes.
And that is that in order for people to come to know the one true God, someone had to die.
Oh, but who was the one true God?
Okay.
And Jesus did that.
Okay, David.
I just want to ask him another question on this.
No wonder he's been...
This is at least one verse we have brought in the discussion where the identification of the true God, who it is mentioned by Jesus Christ. You believe Jesus is God. Are there verses anywhere in the entire New Testament where Jesus identifies likewise that he's also God? Explicitly.
That is exactly a very important issue, and exactly what I told you. It's Jesus. First of all, he did not want to say it in the beginning at first because he already had work to do. He had to go and preach and tell his teaching and develop the new disciples. It only was at the very end, right before he died, when in front of the high priest, he said, so you are saying you are making yourself equal with God. He said, what you said is true. That's when it happens.
I've understood.
Yeah.
But I want to make it contextualized. Imagine now, this is the time of Christ and I'm Christ on earth, right? I'm not telling you that I'm God on earth, God of Israel, that you should be worshipping me and listening to me, that you should not even lift your finger and say anything bad to me. I don't say anything. So you think God out of this magnificent cosmos, you know how big our cosmos is, came down on this tiny planet, and then he's to tell the people that he's God and he should worship.
No, that he's the Messiah.
Sorry,
not that he's God. The primary thing was the Messiah.
Sorry, you're not letting me setting the scene.
Primarily.
So he comes along, yeah, and he doesn't tell anyone plainly that he's actually God on earth, the God of Israel on earth.
He gets stoned straight away. And he wouldn't last one day.
People see him going around and calling,
a
mighty prophet has arisen, who's doing miracles, healing the blind, curing the lepers. So people confuse him as a prophet, as a prophet,
he went straight to heaven,
as an agent of God.
The body wasn't God.
Yep. And some people are even questioning whether he's the Messiah or not.
Yeah.
So if he was God, like, I'm God now, why am I not telling the people that I'm God on earth?
And he's telling us the other is a God.
Did. Right at the very end.
Or instead, I am telling the people throughout, you shall have no other God besides him. The one in heaven, worship him. Pray to him. Him only you shall serve. So throughout my time, I'm telling you, the God that you worship, should worship, is in heaven. Where, I'm here.
Where the Lord is now.
Wait.
Jesus Christ is now.
And you're expecting.
Which you won't
and
accept.
I'm expecting as God on earth, astaghfirullah, to at least hope that David and Hashem and all the others will somehow understand that I'm God on earth, come to tell you that I have come to save you so that you can believe in me that I am God on earth, while I'm telling you totally opposite. Is that what you pictured this event?
Exactly, because at the beginning, the president of Uganda, it's very weird for him to have to go say, I'm president of Uganda, I'm president of Uganda. But of course, at the very end, when they say, are you the president of Uganda? Then he doesn't deny it. But it's not his job, and it would be very wrong for him
to go around such an encounter in the Bible.
Exactly, yeah.
Where people are saying, you are God, and says, yeah, you're true.
And deny it.
It is an encounter. It has been fed to you by some kind of, you know,
scriptures.
Stretch of
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Text. It doesn't say at all anything. So, would you mind quoting the scripture on this regard?
Yeah, the scripture is.
Which scripture says that?
The whole of the New Testament.
No. The scripture where Christ, at the end of his life and mission, he actually doesn't deny he was God.
David asked Peter, who do people say that I am? You are the Son of the living God. God, this is revealed to you from
Son,
Almighty.
Not God.
You're the Son of the living God.
Mark, Son doesn't mean God Almighty.
No, he's the Son.
If the Son meant that, then
he's one with the
Son.
And he's the Messiah.
Adam would be the
God can multitask. Why are you living?
So where is God only Jesus Christ at the end identifying
him as God?
My God can do many. Jesus, the way, the truth, the life, the good shepherd. He is all these
things. Human sacrifice.
He's the Messiah. He's the Son of God. And he is God at the same time. Because God can do miracles.
Can God die by creation?
Jesus did miracles all the time to show who he was.
Can God die by his own creation?
He is the Son of God. His body died.
So was his body?
He said, into thy hands I commit my spirit.
Good.
Why? Because David.
What is body God?
David, what does he say?
Actually, we do like Dawood. But you seem to be obsessed by that.
You took the piss out of me because I said
I didn't take the
word. Well, you did.
I said you like the word. I said you like the word Dawood.
Yeah,
I didn't take the piss.
I didn't take a piss. That's okay.
So Hashim, your name is
David. It's a low way to go. It's a low way.
Look, you said the body died. Is the body God? Is the body God?
The prophet.
Is the body of Jesus God?
It's the body. It's a temporary body.
But is it God?
He's coming back according to what John said.
Say, you do not even answer the question.
He hasn't said anything.
So the question is this. You're saying the body died. The question
body
is very simple.
Listen to the question, Dawood.
If you're saying the body died, the question is this. Is the body of Jesus Christ part of the triune God?
No.
Good.
It's a temporary Jewish body.
Good. So the Jewish body is not
Miriam.
The Jewish body is not part of the Trinity. The question to you is this. You said your God or the Savior saved you from eternal damnation by dying for you.
And rising from the dead.
Yeah, good.
So now the question is that
because it is a body which died, a Jewish body or whatever it is, from the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit who died for you.
Who came to what?
Who died for you?
Jesus was.
From these three, who died?
Yeshua was born.
From these three, who died?
In Bethlehem. He came from everlasting.
I don't want to know his biography.
Focus.
I'm giving you the full answer, which you won't accept.
Okay, what is the full answer?
The full answer is.
From the Father, listen to the question.
Micah said.
Before you answer.
From eternity, the ruler of Israel, he will come.
Now listen to the question before you answer. From the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, the three persons in the triune God, who died for you?
Jesus.
From these three, who died?
Yeah, the Son.
The Son?
The body.
Which means the second?
The body.
But you said the body wasn't part of God. Body. You said body is not God.
No. He's spirit. God is spirit. God is spirit. The Bible.
See what I mean?
God is spirit.
He's confused now himself.
No.
You said the body is not part of God. The question now is because he's not part of God, somebody must have died for you from the three.
Which one?
The body. Let's return. For me.
So he's kind of rush.
You know you lost that.
Are you finished?
Yes.
Carry on.
So Matthew 26 says the high priest.
Can you open this up? Matthew 26.
The Jews, he says, now the chief, 59, Matthew 26, 59, now the chief priests and the whole council were seeking false testimony against Jesus. They may have put him to death, but they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last, two came forward and they said, this man, I'm able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days. And the high priest stood up and said, have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you? But Jesus remained silent. And the high priest said to him, I adjure you by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ.
Slow down. What was the question? If you are what?
Okay, I adjure you by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God.
Right.
Good. So not God.
So the Son of God.
You said God.
Wait.
Okay. Yeah.
If you are the Messiah, the Son of God.
What do you accept?
Not God.
The Son of God. What do you accept? That he is the Son of God.
Yeah, just like Adam was the Son of God. Would you accept?
No, it's not that sense. The Son of God is not in the sense of Adam or any other human.
Firstly, so we have identified quite correctly there is nothing in the New Testament which Jesus is saying, I am God.
Exactly.
Here it refers to his being Christ.
Actually, let me finish the statement.
Carry on. Finish the verse.
Yeah. Because earlier you said he was asked whether he was God and he replied that he agreed with God. But now you said the question that was asked to him, are you the Christ,
the son of
the living God?
Yeah.
Yes? So not God.
The answer is not finished yet.
Carry on.
Because he says, I adjure you by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God. Jesus answered, you have said so, but I tell you from now on you will see the Son of Man.
So he said, you say so.
Yeah,
yes?
Which means it's true.
No. You say so doesn't mean true. It means you're making the allegation.
No.
That's all it means.
That's not what it means.
Okay.
That's not everyone who was there. His life was on the line.
The important thing is that there's a difference between Son of God and God. Do you agree?
No, because in the context, the very next verse, you will see the Son of Man.
Yes.
And he, who
Son of whom? Son of whom?
Son of Man.
Which man?
Well, I'm going to get to that. Because who he was speaking to were the heads of the Jewish community. These are people who knew the Old Testament very well.
Yeah.
And he knew exactly how they think.
And what?
And he knew that the Son of Man was a phrase from the Old Testament when the book of Daniel, which was very clearly referring to God.
Okay. Yeah. So in the book of Daniel, let me ask you this.
Exactly
in the book of Daniel,
that's why the king, the high priest, tore his clothes and said it's blasphemy.
One, can you? The important thing is this. In the book of Daniel, was Daniel. Hold on, buddy. Stop interrupting every time. In the book of Daniel, did the angel call Daniel the son of man as well? Of course, you don't know the scripture. Exactly. If you knew the scripture, you would have said yes then.
I memorized it. It's not that I don't.
You're talking to the Holy Ghost. 666. Okay, now look here, my friend. You know, the important thing is this. We would, regardless of the high priest, I would put still the words and the statement of Jesus Christ above everyone else. And Jesus, if he acknowledges that the Father is the only true God, I think that should settle the matter. If you want to take other people's word to be of more value than Jesus, that's up to you. It's not my prerogative, that's yours. Now let's get back to the crucifixion, which we are discussing.
Now, I found the references, we just wrote it. There are several apostolic fathers who mentions Christians of not believing the traditional view of crucifixion. Ignatius, Polycarp, Justin, Irenaeus that we mentioned earlier, Tertullian, Hippolytus. The books...
This is very interesting.
Yes. And the books, apocryphal books of the New Testament, like Gospel of Peter, the Apocalypse... Apocalypse of Peter, Second Treatise of the Great Set, the First Book of Eu, the Acts of John.
Second.
Yeah. So let me give you some. Let me give you some quotes now. Let me give you some quotes. So here is a quote. So some examples of quakes clearly saying that it wasn't him, it was someone else dying instead. Look.
Oh, is this about the crucifixion?
This is the Second Treatise of the Great Seth, right? I did not die in reality, but I'm just highlighting a few important facts, right? For my death, which they think happened to them in their error and blindness, since they nailed their man unto their death. It was another, their father, who drank the gall and the vinegar. It was not I. They struck me with the reed. It was another, Simon, who bore the cross on his shoulder. I was another upon whom they placed the crown of thorns. But I was rejoicing in the height over all the wealth of the archons, of the offsprings of their error, of their empty glory. And I was laughing at the ignorance. Yep. So it wasn't Christ. He says it wasn't me. It was another person. So you have another person in the second treatise of the great set.
Let me get the picture of that too.
Yeah.
Good.
So if you were to go in this links, this is Gnostic writings, Nag Hammadi. You can go and read the whole text.
Yeah.
So there are lots of texts which clearly
shows. I talk to a lot of Muslims, and you're the first one who's given me evidence of this stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why I told you that don't talk to Tom, Dick, and Harry people.
So we just want to, you know, conclude on this. Okay, I think so. We have to make our move.
No,
you can conclude on your terms.
Very convenient. Look,
look. You are trying to say, look.
Between Muslims and Christians,
no one's forcing each other to believe in anything. We can live with our differences still, understanding each other's belief system, and it's not a problem. If you want to remain a Christian, that's your choice.
Please.
Try not to be.
Not at all. Not at all.
Don't be radicalized.
I'll lose my life.
I hope you're not radicalized by that.
Sorry, what?
I hope you're not a radicalized Christian.
Yes.
So what I'm saying is,
if he believes he's going to be
whatever our faiths are, we can still live in this world in mutual tolerance, respect, and harmony, and understanding. We can have this bridge between us closer rather than dividing us so much apart and have the hatred and bigotry, because at the end of the day, whatever we believe is our own choice. I cannot force you to believe. You cannot force you to believe. All the things that we've done so far, you can have your words. All that we've done is trying to reason with you from your own scriptures, where we have reasons to believe that even the scripture of the Christians demonstrate that Christ was a monotheist, he had a God, he worshipped his God, and he told people to worship that God only. That only.
And the right hand of the Lord. The
things that you said about him actually were either vague or he wasn't there. So there are interpretations that you can hold, which upon close scrutiny I would say it doesn't really hold up.
Sure.
But that's my opinion. Yeah. That's my opinion.
And
at the end of the day, what I want to say on this final note is this.
Finishing off your
There is a reality that there is a creator God.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
We all should, with all our heart and mind and soul, dedicate our life to worship of this one true God, which Jesus identifies as the Father only.
Yes.
And according to Islam, we say his name is Allah Ar-Rahman. He has all the most beautiful names. So let us at least agree that we come together in worshipping none but God and don't associate any partner with him. Yeah? and come to this.
To believe that Jesus is the Lord?
Yeah, because that. In Islam,
that. No, that's his first name.
If anyone who associates a partner with God,
yes. Are you trying to force us to believe in Jesus? Why are you saying that?
The doors of heaven will be closed, according to Islamic teaching, and the hellfire will go to the destination. We don't want anyone to go to hellfire. Yeah. So this is our humble invite to you to look into Islam, which invites you to the worship of this one true God. The God of Jesus, the God of Moses, God of Abraham, Isaac. The God of Muhammad, peace be upon them.
And I would just say, and I think it's good what he said, is that I really appreciate that you care so much that you even come here and try and persuade them. Because let's be honest, there's a lot of people who despise people who are not like them. They can care less. They just say coexist. That's not healthy. What's going on here is very healthy.
We can reason together.
Yeah. Because we're
even with our differences, we can reason.
Yeah. So I appreciate that. I've learned some new things. I've taken pictures. I'm going to research these things. And I think.
And hope we talk again.
Yeah. Yes. And let's be honest.